going to plug in my microphone over there. Start.
What's going on here, music? Come on now. Mute button. Scarlet solo. Wait, is that the way to do it? No. Okay, guys, I lost my music. Hold on. Where is that? There we go. All righty, that seems right. Simon, Sandra, can you hear my voice okay? Is the music okay? All right, groovy. Thank you, guys. Alrighty. Core fitness today with a request for pressing play. I have a request for myself to press. Oh goodness. If only I were 2 inches taller. Okay. So today we're going to do our core fitness with a little general review of posture hints and also some extra love for hands and forearms. Later today, we might also do some use of a wall. If you have a wall nearby, that can be cool. But if not, we'll make do without it. So I'll give both options. All right, let's start with big circles of the shoulders. And I'm bending and straightening those knees straight forward over parallel legs. And big breath in. And exhale, curve it down. Big breath in. Exhale, curve it down. Quicker now, up. Exhale. Breathe in. Exhale. And breathe it in. Start your watches if you haven't yet. Breathe in. Exhale, curve the chest and just pick some carrots out of the ground there. So you're rotating your spine, but we're keeping our hips in the same place. And twist even more, looking up over your shoulder, but hips stay still. And swing those arms forward. Sit back and curl and flat back and arch it and flat back and curl and flat back. Sit down a little lower and rise on up and come to the front. Knees are going to be underneath your hip bones, right underneath those hip sockets. Center of the knees and second toes. And we'll start by sending out and pulling in our abdomen. Just a basic Pilates scoop, in and out and in and out. In and out, in and out, in and out, in and out. And And then take one hand above and one hand below your belly button and try and isolate the upper versus the lower part of your transversus abdominis, which is the thing that squeezes in your abdomen. So relax the whole thing and think about, can you pull in the top part and release that? Can you pull in the bottom part and release that? So my belly button here, the bottom part is from my belly button down to my pubis, and top is from the belly button up to my rib cage. So I'm gonna release. I'm gonna try and pull in just the bottom. Try and release and pull in just the top. Boop, boop, boop. It should be pretty mentally challenging, if not physically challenging. And then can you alternate them or put them in order? So I'm gonna release everything. I'm gonna pull in the bottom. Add the top, pull in, release the bottom, release the top. We did this in the beginning of the semester and it was just looked crazy to everybody. But now you might feel like you can kind of do it once or twice. And if you make it fast, then it does a whole crazy ripple. Can you do it in reverse? So let it all out, pull the top in, pull the bottom in, release the top, release the bottom. Pull the top in. Pull the bottom in, release the top, release the bottom. See if you can roll it. Notice I'm not moving my back here, or at least I'm trying not to move my back here. This is just the flesh of my spine. I'm moving my back a little bit, don't tell. All right, one more time. We're gonna do the same action, bottom up, roll, and bottom down roll. But I want you to add in the thought of squeezing up and in your pelvic floor, yeah? So we're gonna squeeze up and in pelvic floor, release the tummy without the pelvic floor going down, and then in bottom, in top, release bottom but not the pelvic floor, that's a little tricky, release top. Release, pull it in, out, low, but hold your pelvic floor, out, top, hold the pelvic floor, in, release the bottom, release the top. Try it together. Float, float, keep your pelvic floor lifted. Cause nobody wants to wear adult diapers when they're grown up. Okay, relax it all. Pelvic floor engaged, squeeze in and up. Release the whole belly. Keep that pelvic floor engaged. Squeeze the top, squeeze the bottom. Release the top, release the bottom, but not the pelvic floor. Top, bottom, top, bottom, top, bottom, top, bottom. Keep checking on that pelvic floor lift. Top, bottom, top, bottom. Oh, top, bottom, top, bottom, top, bottom, top, bottom. All right, stand on just your right leg. Parallel hips, pelvic floor lifted, wiggle through the belly, without losing your pelvic floor. Next time I'm gonna have you do this at the same time. No, I'm just kidding. Try the other leg. Feels like that, right? Pat your head, rub your belly, hold your pelvic block in. Neutral, keep your pelvic floor engaged and swirl through the belly. Okay, enough of that, yes? Jog it out, let's wake it up. Step wide. Let your buns and your hips go side to side. Let's loosen all that up. Keep lifting in your pelvic floor. Keep your transversus abdominis contracted, which means your Pilates scoop is in. Come center. High knees. Push those feet into the floor. So point your feet as they come off. Turn it out. Stay still. In the center. All right, we'll go wide, wide, narrow, narrow. Keep lifting it up. Switch legs. Add down, down, up, up. Check your pelvis. And we'll go forward, forward, back. So I'm leading with my left leg, but you can lead with either one. Forward, forward, wide, back. Check your scoop, check your pelvic floor still engaged. Good, good. and switch. And narrow, narrow down. How's your scoop? How's your torso? Come center. Bring those legs all the way together, and we're gonna lift our heels and just feel where your balance is to start. Lift, lower. Lift, lower. I feel very much like this today to start with. So I'm gonna reset my pelvic floor, Pilates scoop, lengthen through the back, and try that again. I'm gonna think lift. And when I think lift, I'm gonna think about shifting my pubis forward over my toes. Shift pelvis, shift pelvis, shift pelvis. Good, and square again. Forward, forward, back, back. Now I want you to think pelvis forward on your forward steps. One more square, and march it out to switch sides. Stop wide, sway, make a smile with your hips. Let's circle those arms. Opening up the armpits, opening up the pectoral muscles. Squat down. Lean your butt back in space. Pull those shoulder blades together. How's your scoop? How's your pelvic floor? Shoulder blades. Not just your arms. And no arms, all chest. Good job. Take it up. Walk around, say hello to your friends. Hi, friends. Hello, imaginary friends. Hello, everybody. Come center. Nice wide stance, wider than your outside of your hips. Pelvis, let's just rock through our pelvic clock real quick. So, pelvic floor is in, Pilates scoop. Send it back, the pelvis. There's six, there's neutral, there's 12. There's neutral, there's six. There's neutral, there's 12. You might want to bend your legs a little bit to really feel a good 12. Otherwise, it's kind of hard to pull all the way to that contracted or curved place in the lower behind, lower back. Out, neutral, curve, neutral, six, neutral, 12. Imagining that clock on the front of your pelvis. When we go to 6 o'clock, it goes back in space, 12 o'clock. Otherwise, remembering that at noon, we're so hungry for lunch. Oh, noon, I'm so hungry. And also, at 6 o'clock, you're like, let's go out. All right, hold in neutral, shoulders back. Sink it down, reach out, find flat back. Come back in, shoulders back. Rise to all the way straight spine, and then press up. Yeah, so we're gonna practice holding this aligned spine with our shoulders out. Through, squat, two, three, four, and flat back. Two, three, four, come back upright and low. Shoulders back, flat back, and straighten legs. Two, three, that's it, and down. You'll notice at the very top of it, your butt probably wants to come sticking out. Two, three, four, and upright. Two, three, four, and rise. Keep your neutral pelvis and down. Two, three, four, good. Last one, stay in your flat back. Three, four, drop your shoulders, pull your shoulders together. Four, five, six, seven, eight, arms back, same action. Your back of your arms are trying to touch. And sides. Two, think about your shoulder blades moving, not just your arms. Six, seven, eight, and up high V. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Come upright, rise up. Arms down, head, neck, shoulders, release to a gentle stretch, sway. Let it go. Breathe it up. Roll up slowly, still swaying. come center. Pull those arms back, grab your hands behind you and open up your chest. And let's lean our whole neck and head away from that shoulder. So big stretch on this side. I'm gonna lean away from that shoulder. Nod yes. It's like you're trying to touch your left ear to your left shoulder. Roll other side. Find the stretch first, deep neck stretch. Shoulders back, and then slow nod, slow nod. Come on up. Wake that body back up. Raise the roof. Party in here. Party over there. Party over there too. Come back home. Choose your own adventure, rock it out. Whatever you want, close your eyes, feel the music. Come back center, open those eyes. Comfortable stance, knees slightly turned out, whatever feels comfortable. Just bend and stretch to each side a little bit. Point that foot off the ground. Lift up, shoulders back. Just a little demi-plie and a straightening of the leg. And stay, and down, stay, and down, stay, and down, balance, and down, balance, and down, balance, balance, and down, balance, balance, down. Close that leg. 3, 4, 5, everything here stays lifted up. And switch sides, balance, close and open. And come on down. Step wide, 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 wide. Sway those hips. Make a circle. Trying to loosen all this up. We want fluidity. Want to get the blood pumping into those little tiny attachment points that are slow to wake up. And press it down. Press your knees back in space. So pressing the knees back. I definitely have my weight in my arms, but I'm trying to open the thighs. Big breath. And come on up. Find that comfortable stance where you're slightly turned out, slightly bigger than your width of your hips. Find a neutral spine. It's probably not wherever you're relaxed. You probably have to really fight for that neutral. Shoulders down and, oh, I'm under the short part of the ceiling. Here we go. Send your hips, not your upper body. So just send it over and come up. Come back to neutral or 12 o'clock. Send it out to the side without sticking your booty out. We go to the right. 2, 3, 4, bring it up. Try and keep your ribs right in the same place. Over. 2, 3, 4, shoulders down. Pull down fiercely. Over. 2, 3, 4, now ribs. 2, 3, 4, ribs up, stomachs in, now hips. 2, 3, 4, now ribs. 2, 3, 4, bring them back. 2, 3, 4, send your hips. 2, 3, 4, send your ribs. You gotta get longer, reach with the top of your skull and switch. Your hips and head gets longer, slightly forward and up. 2, 3, 4, and hips. 2, over 2, up 2, hips, 2, over 2, up 2. You should be feeling this in your obliques. We're gonna stay. Bring your hands down. Contract a little more, pull that scoop in a little more, lean your shoulders over a little more, and rotate your heart to the very front of the room. Check those legs, they're not locked. Stay right here, arms up, and we'll go twist. Pull your scoop in, you got it. Lift long through the back of your head. Add the punch. And come up, 2, 3, 4, now hips. 2, 3, 4, and over. 2, 3, 4, check. check it out. In and up. Twist, twist, twist. Remember to hold your legs, but not lock them out. 7, 8, add your arm, 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 arm. And we'll come up, 2, 3, 4, take it down. 6, 7, 8, walk it wide. Check your torso, bounce it down. Think about those knees. Most knees fall in, so I want you to hold those knees open and back. Tiny pulse, it happens under your buns. You go, pulse it, pull them back, pull them back, pull them back, pull them back. Open those, rotating your thighs open. Open, 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 hold, stay there. Snap it out. You've got it, snap it out. Bring it up. Okay, let it go. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Coming back center, legs and toes. Stand on the right, pulse the left leg up. Nothing else moves in your torso. Shoulders are back, ribs are in, stomach is in. Scoop. Take it to the side. Try not to lift those hips. The urge is gonna be for your hip to go with your leg. Take it forward and stepping onto your left leg. And right leg up, pulse. Check yourself, shoulders back, ribs together, scoops in, pelvic floor is engaged, and you're pulling that belly button over your standing leg to the side. Good. Okay, we'll step it back. I'm gonna stand on your right thigh back. 2, 3, gotta really pull up, like you're pulling up the front of your pants here. Okay, now turn that knee out without going to the side. Back there. Think about this hip coming forward as you lift it back with your buns. Lifting, 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 lifting. 5, 6, 7, 8, and stand on it. Whoosh. Okay, now your right foot's going straight back. Pelvis wants to go to 6 o'clock, but you're gonna pull it back to neutral. Push that leg back in space. It's like your thigh is trying to push the back wall. Keep lifting up. Don't let that tailbone sneak away. Okay, okay. And open. Take it up and back. Here we go. Open. Keep that knee backwards. Keep that hip forwards. Good, good, and forward. Both feet together, roll it down. Ha! Big stretch. Walk your hands forward and your feet back to come to your modified plank. Press it back. Arch through that spine. Ah! Curl it and roll it back up. Big breath in. Tuck your tailbone underneath just a little bit. Let those thighs open for a hot sec. Notice if you feel tight where the quadriceps are reaching down to your knees. Notice whether your knees tend to roll in or out. Try and find parallel. That might mean a little squeezing. Exhale, curve, curve, curve. We'll rise up, keep your curve, press your feet to the floor. We'll go deep. 2, 3, 4, flat back. 6, 7, 8, and nose, chin, chest passes through. Modified plank pushes up. 4 more times. Keep your 12 o'clock down. 4, 3, 2, 1, up and curve it home. Roll up. Feel your thighs stretch out. Reach your toes back behind you and curve, and curve, and curve, and curve, curve, curve. Rise up, squeeze your thighs. Keep your pelvis tipped back. Curve it deeper, friends. You know where it's at. Take it forward. Flat back hover. Nose, chin, chest, elbows in. Press up we go. Four, three, shoulders back. One, and take it down to the floor and take a nap. 5 second nap. Everybody loves the 5 second nap. All right. From your 5 second nap, we're gonna initiate by pulling this pelvic floor up and then your Pilates scoop in. And then release your Pilates scoop, but not the floor. And then release the pelvic floor. Just a few of those isolations. Floor, scoop, scoop, release, floor, release, floor, scoop, scoop, release, floor, release, scoop, scoop, release, floor, release, floor, scoop, scoop, release, floor. Now that you've remembered what that feeling is like, we're gonna add in 12 o'clock. Floor, scoop, 12 o'clock pelvis. So my hip bones came off the floor and now my thighs are on the ground there and my ribs, yeah? Little bit of space in between. Release that position of the pelvis, but hold your scoop. Release your scoop, but hold your pelvic floor and then relax the pelvic floor. Notice when your butt muscles might just like decide to participate. So notice how that happens. Here we go, we'll go floor, scoop, 12, release, unscoop, unfloor. Floor, scoop, 12, release, unscoop, unfloor. Floor, scoop, 12, release, unscoop, unfloor. Floor, scoop, 12, stay there, everybody. Find that nice flat lower back and go swimming. Pull those hips out. Feel your legs extending super long behind you. Take your arms forward. Pull your shoulders back, legs together on the floor. We'll go head up, neck up, shoulders right, arm. At this point, most everyone's gonna lose that back to an arch trying to engage with those lower back muscles. You don't get to use them. Keep your 12 o'clock pelvis. Here we go, we'll go head, neck, shoulders, left hand. Notice I'm not going all the way up because that uses other muscles. I just wanna lift the shoulder weight. It feels like it goes backwards because I'm anchoring my shoulder blade. Okay, alternating. Here we go. Head, neck, shoulders, right, arm. And down. Two, three, four. And head, neck, shoulders, left, arm, and down. Two. How's your scoop? And head, neck, shoulders, right, arm, and down. Two. How's your pelvic floor? Head, neck, shoulders, left arm, and next one, we're gonna do both hands. You go head, neck, shoulders, both arms, and down. Two, keep it small, pay attention to your lower back. Shoulders, both arms, keep it small. Pay attention to your scoop. Notice how your shoulders, both arms can put pressure downward into your pelvic floor. Neck. Shoulders, both arms, stay there. Kick, 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 kick. Hands, press it up, back. Downward dog. Curl that lower back, stretch through each leg. Shake that head out. Bend your knees and gently extend and bend your knees. And notice that they both should be parallel. Don't let them go wonky, stay parallel. Put those knees down, bend your arms to the elbows on the floor, not to the sides. Straight back, yeah? And straighten. Point your fingers straight forward, as wide as your shoulders. Most of us tend to put them a little wide. Bend down. Find those Sphinx arms. Adjust as needed. Find your scoop and floor, press up. Two, three, four, and down. Two, scoop and floor, shoulders back. Send it up. Three, four, take it home. Two, three, four. How do your shoulders feel? Did they sneak up on you? Let's anchor them back down. Press. Two, three, stay there. Bent legs, bring a left leg up. And push the ceiling, push, 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 push. Push, bring it down. It's not very high. I'm using my buns, not my whole leg. Switch legs. Bring it up, two, three, four, and push. Keep your hips square. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Switch legs down. Two, three, four. Take it down. Come back, roll it up. Give your arms a break, big hug. Back in place, come up. Shoulders back, stomachs in and left. Two, three, four, five, six. Think about the heel hitting the ceiling, take it down. Two, right leg up. Four, press four. Two, three, four again. Five, six, seven, eight. Take it down, home. Two, knees down. Tuck it in. Roll it up. Big hug. Hug yourself. Curve forward, stretch out the back. Drop your head, wind it down. Hands on the floor. Press them right underneath your shoulders. Drop that belly, lift it. Drop it. Notice my hands already, my elbows already went hyperextended. That's probably where you went too. So make sure we're a little bit soft there. Here we go. Soft shoulders. Roll them back. Elbows are not hyperextended. Hold those scoops and alternate. Right hand, left leg. Keep it slow. It's about a flat back. And left hand, right leg. Keep it slow. Don't go very high. Up. This is not about your buns, it's about stabilizing your core, yeah? Keep that scoop in, keep those shoulders back. Micro bend in the elbow. Notice whether your hips are swaying side to side or not, hopefully not. Good, good, good. Take it down. Time for Amber's magical butt exercise. You're gonna slide your right leg all the way forward, yeah? And then I want you to just rock back for a second. Get those booties down. Make sure that foot is way far ahead, yeah? Like you're about to propose. Hands down, they're close to my foot. Stretch that foot out if you can, doesn't have to be straight. Find that flat back, and we'll go lift two. Don't move your hips. Five, six, seven. 1 millimeter height is fine. Circle. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Reverse. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Take it back and tuck it in. Send your hips back and then over that side to stretch it. Watch your hands the other way. Curl up like a little kitty cat. Z, 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 Z. Letting that hip stretch out. Unwind. Slide lefty around. Stretch it out. Flip your wrist over. Put your knuckles on the floor. And then let your wrist pass your knuckles as you relax that hand. Same with the other second. So you're stretching this section of your wrist. All right, come on up. Shoulders back, scoops in parallel to the floor with the hips. And eight, eight, eight. We'll go eight, lift. Two, three, four. Don't use your whole butt. Six, seven, eight. Circle back. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. It's magical. Switch directions. Two, three. Try and put even weight in both arms. You're done. Take it back and tuck it. Press back. Drop the hips to that side and curl up like a sleepy kitten. All right, come on down to your backs. Wait. take a moment to remind yourself of what it feels like to pull in that Pilates scoop and lift up that pelvic floor. Lift, curl, release, release. Lift, curl, release, release. Add in that extra step of sticking your belly all the way up in the air and then hollowing out your torso. So now we're gonna go floor, scoop, curl, release. Floor, scoop, curl, release, release. Floor, scoop, 12 o'clock, neutral. Unscoop, release your floor. Floor in, scoop in. 12 o'clock, neutral. Scoop out. Floor in, scoop in. 12 o'clock, neutral. All right, stay in your scoop and pelvic floor in. Curve to 12 o'clock. Really nuzzle your lower back into the ground. I want you to just take your lower back and be like, nuzzle it down into the lower ground. Think about your belly button trying to plant itself like it's a seed and wants to get deep into that earth. Luscious, down, deep feeling, yeah? And then grow those roots out, belly button root. And we're just going to pull our arms into the earth as well. So all the way from your shoulder through your elbow and your hand. Feel the whole arm connecting. That should fire up your upper back. And we're gonna go for a walk. Everything's trying to smoosh into the earth, except your tailbone, which is just slightly curved up, yeah? Everything else is down. Tiny walk. Imagine one of those really long canoes, like a dragon boat. And think about your torso being the part where all the people are. All of that is pressed into the surface of the water. And at the end, you have two little parts that rise up. So your tailbone is just sent slightly curled up. And then we're gonna also curve our head, neck, and shoulders. Find that spot, and then take a moment, reset everything nice and deep. Deepen in, compressed in. Centering, pulling together your strength, yeah? Head and shoulders are up, tiny walks. Now you can see your scoop. Is it going out and in, pull it in. And you can also see your hip bones. Your hip bones will probably wanna go for a walk with your legs. Save that salsa for the chips. You gotta pull it still. Good. Walk those legs, go up. And belly button down, shoulders up. Think long back of the neck, chin in. You got this, friends. Walk on the sky. Whoop, whoop. Deepen that scoop. Curl your hips off the floor like you're walking over yourself. And hug legs. Relax the neck. Just rock your head side to side. You will notice at this point if you chose an uncomfortable place for your ponytail. Let your hair get messy. Let it get messy. Especially those of you with really short hair, I'm sure you know exactly how that feels, right, guys? Or girls. People with short hair are like, hair, I don't, why do you bother? All right, bend your knees. Whew, hollow out your core. Squeeze those legs all the way together. Point those feet. Let's do hip ups. So we're belly buttons down and teeter-totter up the hips. We go pulse and lower and pulse and lower and pulse and lower and pulse and lower and pulse. Stay off the ground with your tailbone. Bend your knees. Two, and straighten. Release those arms and bend. Flex and straighten. Keep your tailbone up and bellies in. Legs press, hips off the ground. As you double leg stretch, pull it in. Rest. Inhale, head, neck, and shoulders up. Double leg stretch with arms open. Out, keep your 12 o'clock close and open. Out, keep your 12 o'clock close and open. Out, keep your 12 o'clock close. One more. Out, keep your 12 o'clock close. Rest your head. Knees twist to the left. Take a break and twist that spine open. Delicious. Switch sides. Roll over. Knees forward. Finding that nice flat torso. Reaching down your back. Checking to see if your lower back is flat. Scoop. Release. Pelvic floor. Scoop. Scoop, release. Floor, release. Scoop. Floor. Scoop, release. Floor, release. All right, hold it all in place. Pull those shoulders down. Just feel what happens here in the neck, between the neck and the floor. Now, sometimes it gets uncomfortable on the hand here, so you can leave this hand making a shelf in this direction. You can try flipping it over in the other direction, getting a stretch on the back of the wrist. You can try a fist, or you can occasionally just put the head down on the arm. But before we go there, let's try pulling, anchoring that shoulder blade down. And notice how this little tiny space becomes enough room for a very small dog like Toto to go through it. Arf! So leave room for Toto. Nice long neck. Scoops are in, ribs are in. Now our legs, we go clamshell open, close. Otherwise known as froggy office chair. Keep those heels forward the whole time. So I'm just rotating. I'm not, even though it looks like it, I'm not pulling my thighs closer to my face at all. I'm trying to think about them opening like a fan. All right, hold open, tap wider. Three, find room for Toto. And close. Open, kick, bend. Close all the way. There's a little temptation to not let it go. Let it go. Hold on to this instead. Here we go. We'll go froggy. Kick. Bend. Close all the way. Check, check. Froggy. Kick. Bend. Close all the way. Check, check. Froggy. Open. Bend. Close all the way. Take your top leg, swing it down so it's in straight line with your body. Drop it to the floor. Notice how it pulls your hip. Line those hips up on top of each other and lift that leg. Hips are not moving. Check room for Toto to get through. Check room for your belly button and torso to pull in. Is your leg drifting forward? Keep it straight in line. So when I look down, I should only see my toes poking out. Yeah, I can't see my whole leg. Good. Bring it forward. Straighten it like a rocket. Bring it back. Oh, how about this? Imagine you're skateboarding, but you're also a rocket. You're a skateboarding rocket. You're going to kick that beautiful leg forward and then push your skateboard. Swoosh, whoosh. Practicing perfect parallel. You'll notice your knee might have, some of us might have weird little feelings in the knee, so we're going slow and we're really thinking about that alignment. Take it back. Check, check, check. Push back. Push back. Push back. The whole thigh. Back and up. Back and up. Back and up. You should feel your whole glute. Back and up. One more time. Back and up. And bring it in. Number four stretch. Should feel fantastic right now. We just used all those external rotating muscles. All right, big breath in. Big exhale. Relax the pecs. Relax the chest. Exhale, Pilates scoop. Pelvic floor engaged, ribs down, shoulders down, head, neck, and shoulders up. Grab that number four, pull it closer to your face. Balancing on your lower back. Send your left leg out to where it's a challenge. Your challenge. Shoulders down, take your head back. Breathe. Deepen, pull in and up. Lower that leg 2 inches. Don't lose your lower back on the floor. If you did, bring that leg all the way back up. Everybody bring the leg all the way back up and find a new extension with your lower back on the floor. And bring it back in. Relax the head, neck, and shoulders. Unfurl those legs. Switch sides. Both knees in. Both legs up in the air. Enjoy a nice stretch here. Bring it through. Find those straight hips. Notice when we bring the leg to the front, your hips want to fall with it. So I want you to think about holding that scoop in, making room for toe to sneak through, so my shoulder blades down into the earth, and lifting this hip so it's square. So then I want to stroke that leg back, press through, push off on my skateboard, and extend it to the front. And notice all the little changes in stabilization that happen just to keep this going. I want my thigh to stay parallel. It's much trickier than it seems, right? Because most of us want to go like, but that won't get you very far on your skateboard. So, rockets on skateboards, press through those legs, boosh, big push off. Bring that knee through, boosh. One more. And come to your number 4 stretch. Good job, guys. If you don't feel this in your hip, Here's some things you can do to increase it. One, you can push the thigh away as you pull this thigh in closer. Whether this is bent or straight is mostly just personal comfort. You can also reach your bent leg arm through and pull the other thigh closer. And then I can use my bent leg arm to push that knee a little further away. Big breath in. Exhale, pull your scoop in, pull your pelvic floor, deepen that into the earth. Curve to 12 o'clock. Shoulders down, inhale, head, neck, and shoulders up. Option to extend that top leg. Hold on to just this bent leg, balancing on your lower back. Find a long neck and a long leg and explore your balance, keeping your scoop in, thinking about your shoulders. Reset. Deepen that scoop. Breathe. And bring it up. Release your head, neck, and shoulders. Both knees into the chest. Let's circle those legs. And send the feet up to the sky. Hollow out that core. Head, neck, and shoulders are gonna come up. Hands behind the thighs, bend the knees. And curve up to roll like a ball. Roll it back. We're gonna reach up and balance. And take it back in and roll back. And reach up. And again, roll back. I'm gonna talk about this hand phrase a little bit more. So I call this judgy flamingos, disappointed flamingos. Because it looks like flamingo heads, right? And they're like, I don't know about this. I'm judging, right? Very judgy flamingo heads. So when I do this, I can really feel my forearm flexing. So I'm taking two things. While you're balanced there, you're doing this, right? I'm going to pull my center of my palm back in space and try and get this heel of my palm and the base of my thumb to both come together, almost like I'm squeezing a little blueberry there. And then I take all my fingers together and I pull this little pinchy thing down and flex my forearm, yeah? So there's my disappointed flamingos. And the opposite of disappointed flamingos is, I'm 10 years old! Yeah, stretching your palms as far as you can, really reaching through all those fingers. Feel a stretch in your palms. Okay, let's integrate that. Here we go. On your balance point, nice long straight back. We're gonna come up with our flamingos. They're gonna go, I don't know about this. Whee! And roll like a ball. And flamingos, straighten your legs with your whee. Come back in, curve back. And balance point, disappointed flamingos. Whee, straight legs. Grab, curl, roll like a ball. Dink. Dink, whee, dink, roll it back. Come on up, butterfly stretch. I see some people are doing our check-in number two. Go ahead and check-in number two. And then when you come back down to your butterfly stretch, we're trying to let these knees open as far as possible. And I'm gonna take my palms, thumbs out, and I'm gonna show you that there's nothing in my hands. Yes, and I'm gonna put all of my fingertips together onto the floor and then press the heels of my palms forward past the knuckles. And this stretch now should stretch all the way up your forearms here, all the way up your forearms. So I'm almost trying to put my palms back on the floor, but there's not enough room. Now, if you run out of room there because you're so flexible, you can scoot your hands forward. You should feel the stretch through the fingers, the palms, and up your forearms. Breathe. Release and flip them palms down. Let your wrists pass your knuckles. Come on up. Let's bring our legs together. So we're gonna prepare now for the up the wall section. I want you to have true parallel legs for this, so make sure you're not doing whatever it is your legs do. This is what mine do. Yeah, so I'm gonna hold them parallel, thumbs up. I'm gonna bend my knees so I'm not stressing behind the knee tendons or behind the hip socket tendons. And I'm gonna walk my booty back with my fists under my knees and have a deep hamstring stretch here. Yeah, so you want to feel it in the body of the muscle, not behind the joints. Yeah, so it can be super bent. Super bent is fine as long as you're feeling right here. Big deep breaths. Go ahead and take your hands down to your lower back. And give yourself a nice little gentle rub or pat, whatever feels nice. I like to sometimes grab a handful of imaginary marshmallows. Imaginary marshmallows. Imaginary mushrooms would work too. And tap out that lower back gently. So you're just gently rocking out the tension with a handful of marshmallows. All right, walk your hands up as far as you can onto your ribs and squeeze those shoulders, your elbows and shoulder blades together, and then lift your chest. Notice how those arms want to come out to the side and squeeze them back a little more. Try and roll your shoulders back in this position. Just squeeze that. Find parallel legs and squeeze them all the way together. Pull your scoop in, sit up tall. Release. All right. Pat yourself on the shoulders and then pat yourself on the neck. And we're going to go up, but we are not going to go on the neck at all. So this lump where we had that video talking about slouching, making that lump stick out, we want to be in this next action. We want to be across the shoulders, but not past that lump. All right. So if you have a wall is ideal for this. It's okay if you don't, you can do it on the floor. I will do it on the floor and the wall to demonstrate. But also would work a couch. If the bottom of your couch is nearby, that would work too. Okay, so on the floor first, everybody on the floor, because we're gonna practice how our bodies feel. So just on the floor, we're gonna do the totally not new to you. Floor in, scoop in, and we're gonna roll up through, I'm gonna move my arm just so you can see better, roll up through your bridge, yeah? So I want you to not get sky high like we do in yoga, but only get so that your weight is on your shoulder blades on your back, arms are down. Notice how your ribs might wanna come out. Don't let them, I want you to find that scoop. And we've been working all day on pulling that core in. Parallel thighs. And so we're just going to roll up and down to our bridge, articulating the spine, which means you want to feel each vertebrae of your spine leave and return to the floor. So pelvic floor, Pilates scoop, 12 o'clock pelvis, peel your tailbone off, peel your lower back off, your rib cage up to the top of your back, not past the top of your neck, and back down. 5, 6. Feel the moment when your lower back touches, but your butt does not. Now, I know having some booty back here, that is very difficult to find those places. And that's where you're shooting for, is where can you touch the lower back but still keep the booty lifted. And then release your glutes and your hamstrings without losing that 12 o'clock pelvis. Let your core, your front of your core, hold it there. So your abs hold the 12 o'clock without your booty doing it. And you can jiggle your own butt to make sure. Yeah, neutral and release. And pull it in, neutral, 12, roll up, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Check your ribs, check your 12 o'clock squeezing your buns. Roll down, 8 counts, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Pause, release your quads and your glutes, but holding that 12 o'clock. Neutral, 6, neutral, 12, roll it up, nice and slow with control, 2, 1, rolling down, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, find it, neutral, and 12. All right, for those of you who have a convenient wall nearby, we're gonna do exactly the same action, but with your feet as high as your knees. Scooch, scooch. Yeah? So I should see my knees parallel. Same actions. Pull in your Pilates scoop and floor, shoulder blades down, 12 o'clock, roll up, 2. Don't go past your shoulders, the temptation will be strong. Up and down, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hold it, relax your legs and butt, neutral, 6, neutral, 12. Engage those legs, push into the floor, 6, 7, 8. Squeeze, squeeze, down, 2. I lost a little bit of my scoop, how about you? 6, 7, 8, again, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, hold it. Check your scoops. Keep your nose and chin pointed to the ceiling, so you might not be able to see me, and that's okay. Squeeze your guns, and with your glutes squeezed, lift one heel, then the other, so you're walking onto the balls of your feet. 5, 6, 7, 8, roll down, 8. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Find 12 o'clock, neutral. 6 o'clock, neutral. 12 o'clock, engage your legs and butt. Up, 6, 7, 8. Go for a walk, stay high. Don't let your hips move at all. No salsa in the hips. Push through your whole arms. All right, let's go rolling down. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 12 o'clock, neutral. Hug your knees to your chest, good job. Roll it over, onto all fours. Press back into your downward dog. Stretch those legs. Walk your hands in a little bit closer. Bend your elbows. Experiment with taking your right leg off the floor. If you want, you can walk on the floor. And take it back down. All right, let's come back to the mat. Hopefully everybody survived that fun adventure. More to come. All right, we're gonna put our right knee forward, and have a nice pigeon stretch while we talk again about the wrist. Let's go ahead and spread our palms out on the floor here. And we're gonna take our hands, palms facing each other, and then point our fingertips towards each other and push our knuckles together so it looks like a letter M. Yeah, it looks like a letter M. And press those knuckles down. And notice how your thumb comes closer and closer to your forearm here. So we're, now I'm gonna take my left hand, your left hand, and press that action together. Yeah? Release and switch sides. So this is stretching the outside of your wrist, the top of your wrist. All right, release. Switch your pigeon. Stretch one wrist forward. So this is your right wrist. I'm gonna reach around and open the thumb as well. And switch. Release that. Come on up. Okay. I'm gonna come up close for this next one. Okay, so this is gonna be a bend and twist together. So I'm gonna take one hand, and this is an Aikido stretch, so if you, any of you guys have done martial arts, might look familiar. This is your lefty. I'm gonna bring that lefty into that position we just had it against the mat earlier, yes? So it's disappointed flamingo. I'm gonna rotate. So my elbow and my fingers are out, pointing towards you. It's like a very awkward pointing it out. And I'm gonna grab with your right hand, thumb up, around my whole palm. Yeah? Then I'm going to drop both shoulders and both forearms and rotate my whole hand so that my pinky might come up and pick my nose. Yeah, so now I am twisting this forearm. And I'm gonna feel this stretch here. So I'll feel it twisted around here. In, down, twist the fingers back up. So my wrist and forearm are going down and my fingers are twisting up. All right, let's try the other side. Flamingos heads together. Your left hand grabs the right hand. Pull it in, drop it down. Rotate those flamingos' noses up to the sky. Release your shoulders, drop it low. All right, let it go. All right, here's our last one. It's called Pedagogy. So you're gonna take your hand, this is your left hand. Thumbs out to the side, palm is facing you. Yeah? I'm gonna press forward. I'm gonna grab with your right hand. Right hand wraps around the back of the palm. your right thumb is gonna come between your ring finger and your pinky, right into this spot between those two phalanges. Your fingers all together wrap around the base of the thumb. Yeah, so thumb between the ring and pinky knuckles, fingers around the base of the thumb. Now I'm gonna take this blade of your right hand and you're gonna take it to your heart. Again, shoulders down, elbows down, and drop everything earthward. As I drop the wrists downward, you can see how my hand rotates. The pinky's going towards its own armpit. And I'm showing my palm even more to the front, yeah? So the back of my palm is towards my low sternum or belly button. So this is a bend and twist. Bend and twist, kodokai. In Aikido, it is a way to pin someone. You twist them, and they go back. Drop those wrists and forearms. We tend to sneak it up, yeah? You won't feel the stretch if you're an acute angle in your forearms. You gotta bring it down. Loosen it up. Soft. All right. Now your right hand. So your right hand, palm faces you, thumb is to your right. Left hand wraps around. Left thumb between the ring and the pinky. Fingers come around. Pull it in like you're gonna put a ring on in a Beyonce video. In fact, that is exactly the twist you're doing. You're just gonna pull it down in the center so that it bends as well. Kodagash, AKA put a ring on it. Keep dropping it down, keep rotating. So it's a flex and twist. Good, release. All right. Body. Your bottom of your body is like freestyle doing whatever you want. If you want to relax, maybe you're just stretching, sitting, you want to dance it out, you can dance it out. But I want you to massage as a final point. This is for your tennis elbow. This muscle that's on the, okay, so if you give yourself a thumbs up, yes, it's this chunk on your forearm. And if you hitch a ride, hey, hitch a ride. You'll feel that muscle. So I want you to massage through that guy. Deep massage, push in there. If you find a knot in there, just press and breathe. Try not to shrug your shoulders, friends. You can try turning this hand, but keeping this massage pressure down as a way to access any knots that might be in there. And make sure you get the other side, and that's it for today. You did great. Good job, everybody.